An 11-year-old boy died this morning in a car accident on I-44 in Lawton, just south of the Lee Boulevard exit.
This was the scene on the turnpike around 9 a.m. where police found this truck straddling a guardrail. They said the boy had been ejected from the truck and was pronounced dead at the scene.
That is tonight's big story. 7 News reporter Dylan Stevens was at the accident shortly after police responded. Dylan, do we know what caused that accident?
Slick conditions. Lawton police say the truck was heading north on I-44, and when they crossed a bridge, they hit some ice and then they lost control.
The bridge that goes over Bishop Road was extremely icy. It didn't take much for the truck to lose control and then clip another car.
Looks like it lost control, slid sideways for quite some time until it made contact with the guardrail, rolled at least one time, and that's where we're at so far. The vehicle is damaged beyond repair, and that's due to the rolling.
The truck hit the guardrail with such a strong impact, resting some 30 feet away from the impact point. Lieutenant Brad Davis says the 11-year-old wasn't wearing a seatbelt, but he says with this wreck, that might not have even mattered.
But due to the fact that it was a rollover at that capacity, even if he was wearing a seatbelt, there's a possibility he could still have been ejected.
Davis says it was a tough scene to work, not just because of all the variables that go into finding out how the wreck happened, but because of the emotion the death of an 11-year-old brings.
Anytime you're dealing with children, you know, innocent victims such as this, it does make it more difficult, you know, working the scene. It takes a toll on all of us because pretty much all of us out here have children, and, you know, it's just one of those things that, you know, it's part of our job. We have to deal with it and do it, so, but it is difficult.
There were four others in the truck. They were treated for minor injuries at the hospital. Davis says they were also helped at the scene by passing drivers.
The other vehicle involved in the accident was not badly damaged, and the driver was eventually able to drive away. Davis asks drivers to once again buckle up and also remember that bridges and overpasses ice even when the roads don't.
Thanks, Dylan. That was one of three accidents this morning that Lawton police blamed on the icy road. Oklahoma Highway Patrol's Troop G, based in Lawton, worked 14 wrecks that required accident reports, but said they responded to several more minor incidents, such as drivers sliding off the road.